Welcome to this brief guide on how to use generative AI in Google Docs. Generative AI has begun to permeate through a lot of the tools that we use in the office on a day-to-day basis. And so now I'm going to show you how you can introduce it into Google Docs for yourself to use. Here you can see I happen to have the interest page for the Google Workspace Labs. I'll include a link to this in the description of this video. This feature is going to allow us to test brand new generative AI tools before they hit production release. In order to sign up, we will need to agree to the terms of agreement down the bottom here, which you can accept by simply clicking and ticking all three boxes and selecting the submit button at the bottom. This is available to both Workspace accounts and also personal consumer accounts. In a couple of moments, you'll notice that we're in and we're ready to open up a brand new document in order to test out these features. In order to do so, I'm just going to head to docs.new, which will create a brand new document ready for me. And the first thing you'll see is that we'll get a pop-up welcoming us to the Workspace Labs. In order to close down this pop-up, simply select the Got It button in the bottom corner. Now up near my cursor, you'll see that we have a brand new button that says Help Me to Write. Selecting this will expand it out into our prompt field. This here will give us some suggestions around things that we could potentially type a prompt in for, but in this case, I'm going to ask it to help me write an email to my team, thanking them for the wonderful birthday party they threw for me and for the wonderful gifts they got me. Now that I've got my prompt entered in, I can simply select the Create button in the bottom corner to begin creating my rough draft of an email. Now, because this is using generative AI, it will take a few seconds for it to give us our result. But once done, you'll see that we'll have a couple of paragraph, quick email ready, thanking our team, and we can make some adjustments to this if we needed to. But as we scroll down, we have options to rate the suggestion as either good or bad, as well as buttons to help us fully recreate or simply refine our results. Using the drop-down menu next to the Refine button will give us some additional options such as formalizing, shortening, elaborating, or even rephrasing our results. This can help us tailor the result to better suit our needs. I'm going to select the rephrase option, which is going to rewrite just parts of it, but keep the same basic premise of the original email. Yet again, this will take a few seconds before it's done. Now we have our rephrased response. Maybe I thought it's a little bit too long, so I want to make it a bit shorter. So I can use the refine option and select shorten. This will then just make some minor adjustments and shorten it down to maybe one or two paragraphs at most here. And there is my brand new email, one paragraph, short, sharp, and to the point. Now that I'm ready, I can simply select the insert button to insert this result into my document. But what you'll see is that Google Docs has automatically used its Smart Canvas feature and realized that this was an email draft that I'd asked it about. So it's automatically inserted the usual fields that we would like to see, such as the To field where I can quickly and easily select from my contacts, and things such as the Subject field. This is a great way for you to be able to draft up an email, and if you're anything like me, you may like drafting up your emails inside a document instead of inside your email client. So then once I've just made the final adjustments to my email by entering in my name, I'm ready to send it. Now, instead of having to copy and paste it over to Gmail, I can use the Gmail icon up in the top left-hand corner here, and selecting this will open up a brand new tab. And then what you'll notice is it's automatically inserted my email, it's put in the people in the To field, it's put in the subject, and it's put in the email itself. I could quickly come down and hit send, but I also have the options to insert my signature or attach a file or adjust any of the formatting just like I normally would with any other email. And when ready, I simply hit the send button, and in no time at all, I've drafted up and prepared and sent an email all from inside my Google Docs account. And it's worth noting that if I was to delete everything out of this document, the Help Me to Write feature is always available to me, all with this little pen icon found on the side of my page. Selecting that will automatically open up the prompt field ready for me to get some help again. And that is how you use generative AI in Google Docs. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.